good day. Assalamualaikum and good day. Okay, now kita akan masuk kepada lecture kita, kita yang ke-9 berkenaan dengan bearing condition monitoring and fault diagnosis. So, sama seperti yang kita bincangkan sebelum ni, untuk monitoring ataupun condition monitoring bagi gear ya, dan sebagainya. Condition monitoring ini sebenarnya dia secara umumnya digunakan atau bertujuan untuk mengenal pasti kerosakan sebelum kerosakan itu menjadi lebih teruk, dengan tujuan untuk mengurangkan kos dan juga meningkatkan prestasi ataupun performance machinery ataupun jentera yang digunakan. Dan seperti yang kita maklum, condition monitoring ataupun pemantauan keadaan ini adalah satu kaedah yang terkedepan dan merupakan satu alat ataupun ya, apa nama, kegunaan yang amat berguna dalam teknik predictive maintenance ataupun penyelenggaraan secara ramalan. Okay, pengesanan awal dan juga pengetahuan tentang problem ataupun masalah yang dihadapi oleh jentera dan cara untuk nak membuat pembaikan adalah amat-amat mustahak. Okay, terutamanya yang melibatkan jentera di industri, dan juga ini menyumbang kepada keselamatan dan juga operasi yang produktif. Dan dalam hal ini, rolling element bearings ataupun bearing yang berputar adalah salah satu elemen yang penting, okay, kerana ia melibatkan jentera yang berputar lah. So, satu kaedah ataupun satu gerak kerja yang berkesan diperlukan untuk mengurangkan kos pergantian ataupun kos penyelenggaraan dan juga memanjangkan jangka hayat sesuatu mesin tersebut. Okay, baik. Bearing condition ni, bila kita ingin melihat ataupun memantau keadaan bearing, jadi tak boleh tidak kita, we cannot run from the vibration yang terhasil ataupun getaran terhasil. Dan bearing itu dia bergetar kerana berlakunya kecacatan ataupun kerosakan terhadap bearing itu sendiri. Okay, bearing vibrates due to default in bearing itself. Dan cara ataupun kaedah untuk nak mengesan bearing itu adalah menggunakan accelerometer. Dan dalam hal ini, kebiasaannya accelerometer akan mengesan data getaran itu dan dihantar ke FFT analyzer, yang mana dia akan menukar data yang dikesan oleh accelerometer itu di dalam PC, dan kita boleh dapati value frequency, amplitude dan juga displacement yang disebabkan oleh berbagai kerosakan ataupun faults ataupun kecacatan yang dikesan. Dan ianya akan dibuat perbandingan supaya maintenance awal atau penyelenggaraan awal dapat dilaksanakan. Okey, baik. Ini seperti biasa, condition monitoring technique are required to acquire the operation condition data of protesting machine. Okey, ini biasa. Maknanya teknik-teknik condition monitoring ini diperlukan. Okey, untuk mendapatkan data. Dapatkan keadaan mesin yang berputar tersebut. Dan banyak teknik yang boleh digunakan selain daripada teknik vibration analysis, juga boleh menggunakan teknik acoustic emission, current signal, oil and debris monitoring teknik, tomografi teknik, temperature measurement, ya, dan sebagainya untuk nak mengesan keadaan bearing. Dalam hal ini, vibration technique, is the most frequently employed technique for machine condition monitoring. So, biasanya vibration technique, vibration analysis technique adalah yang biasanya digunakan, yang kerap kali digunakan untuk nak mengesan keadaan mesin ataupun untuk buat aktiviti machine condition monitoring. Baik, vibration signal are typically generated by defect in the moving component of the machine, such as defects in a bearing, gearboxes, reciprocating components, and so on. So, seperti yang kita ketahui, bukan hanya ketika mengesan gear condition monitoring, ataupun shaft condition monitoring ke, dalam bearing condition monitoring pun vibration analysis technique juga biasa digunakan. So when a rolling element bearing operates under a faulty condition, an impulse signal will be generated as other bearing component passing through the faulty position. So bila dia element bearing tu dia beroperasi, jadi dia akan berputar. Jadi dari situ dapat satu signal. Signal tu yang akan menentukan sama ada bearing tersebut telah sampai kepada keadaan dia sudah mengalami kerosakan. Dari situ kesan atau isyarat itu akan ditangkap dan ditukar kepada tadi FFT punya analyzer dan dicernakan melalui pemerhatian terhadap amplitude, frekuensi dan sebagainya yang berkaitan untuk nak mengenal pasti apa yang berlaku. Seterusnya satu tindakan diambil untuk nak mengatasi kerosakan tersebut. Baik, untuk bearing condition monitoring ni, faults dia ada pelbagai. Antaranya yang melibatkan inner ring damage, outer ring damage, rolling element damage, combination of all three damages stated above. Okay, combination daripada inner ring, outer ring dan rolling element damage, dan juga severe damage. Ini yang kerosakan yang teruk lah, severe damage. Bearing fault analysis pula, dia ada berbagai teknik. Okay. Antaranya time domain data analysis teknik, frequency domain data analysis teknik, time frequency analysis, statistical based bearing fault diagnosis, dan juga bearing fault diagnosis based on artificial intelligence ataupun machine learning. Untuk time domain data analysis teknik, dia adalah satu cara yang kita mengenal pasti time series. Dia melalui kaedah matematik dan data itu diuruskan secara bersiri dan menggunakan kaedah statistik. Manakala untuk frequency domain analysis technique, Ia merupakan satu kaedah yang popular kerana frekuensi domain analysis teknik ini, dia transform time domain data kepada discrete frequency component menggunakan Fourier transform. Dan dalam bearing punya analisis ini, biasanya spektrum yang akan dilihat adalah power spectrum dan dibandingkan dengan power substrum. Ada kalanya ia juga menggunakan kaedah pengesanan melalui envelope spectrum. Dan ini juga adalah merupakan satu benchmark method dalam mengenal pasti bearing fault diagnosis. Kaedah envelope spectrum ni adalah satu benchmark untuk roller element bearing. Dan kaedah ini dia deal hanya dengan signal yang stationary atau stationary signal. Okay, kita faham dulu stationary signal ada dua, satu signal yang ada dua, satu stationary signal, satu lagi unstationary signal. Okay, untuk bearing ni dia deal dengan hanya stationary signal, hanya dari satu sumber yang berterusan. Seterusnya, time frequency signal. Okay, time frequency signal ni berbeza dengan frequency domain data ataupun data analisis teknik. Time frequency analisis teknik ni dia deal dengan transient ataupun non-stationary signal. Jadi dia lebih advance berbanding dengan frekuensi domain data analisis teknik. Jadi kerana time frequency analisis teknik ni dia gabungan antara frekuensi domain dan time domain, dan dia lebih complete lah pengesanannya. Manakala statistical based bearing fault diagnosis, dia menggunakan biasalah menggunakan RMS ataupun root mean square statistical method, ataupun menggunakan absolute mean value, variance dan sebagainya, standard deviation. Jadi dia menggunakan kaedah statistik. Okay. Dan seterusnya untuk yang lebih advance, yang lebih popular digunakan sekarang adalah menggunakan artificial intelligence method yang menyentuh tentang machine learning, dan ini dia lebih kepada Markov models, okay, artificial neural network, deep neural network. Jadi yang ini yang lebih canggih lah yang digunakan sekarang, kaedah digunakan sekarang untuk nak mengesan bearing fault ataupun untuk diagnosis terhadap bearing fault ataupun kerosakan bearing. Jadi seterusnya kita lihat video ini untuk kefahaman yang lebih lanjut.
So what is a bearing fault frequency? Well, an anti-friction bearing or rolling element bearing consists of four parts: the inner race, the outer race, the rolling elements, and the cage assembly. A problem or defect in any one of these four parts will generate a vibration at its own unique, predictable frequency. In fact, the bearing manufacturer will provide the four frequencies. They are the ball pass frequency inner race, the ball pass frequency outer race, the ball spin frequency, and the cage or fundamental train frequency. The frequencies are often abbreviated as shown. At first, the abbreviation may seem a little difficult, but you'll start to remember them soon enough. The question is, what do the frequencies mean? Well, let's look closer at a sample bearing. We'll draw a line across both races between two rolling elements. We'll use the line to help us observe what happens when the bearing is in motion. Let's say the outer race is fixed and that the inner race is turning with the shaft. Look at the mark on the inner race and count the number of rolling elements it passes in one rotation of the shaft. There's one, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and maybe a little more. When we look at the manufacturer's ball pass frequency in a race, we find a value of 12.04. And we now know what the value means. It's the number of rolling elements that a specific point on the inner race will pass with each rotation of the shaft. If the mark on the race represents a rough spot, a ball pass frequency inner race vibration will be generated at 12.04 times the turning speed of the shaft. The resulting frequency we would refer to as a fault frequency. The number provided by the manufacturer is often referred to as a multiplier of shaft speed. Now, let's look at the mark on the outer race and count the number of rolling elements that will pass across it in one rotation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and maybe a little more. Looking at the manufacturer's literature, we find a ball pass frequency outer race of 9.02. If there is a defect in the outer race, 9.02 rolling elements will cross it with every rotation of the shaft. So an outer race vibration will be generated at a frequency equal to 9.02 times the turning speed. Now let's draw a mark through the center of a rolling element. This time we'll count the number of times it spins in one rotation of the shaft. 1, 2, 3, and part of another. In the manufacturer's literature, we find a ball spin frequency multiplier of 3.73. If there is a defect in one or more of the rolling elements, a fault frequency will be generated at 3.73 times shaft speed. Now let's look at a bearing with a more visible cage assembly. You'll notice that the cage and rolling elements are slowly working their way around the center of the bearing, in the same direction as the inner race. In the majority of industrial bearings, the cage will complete approximately 35% to 45% of one rotation with each rotation of the shaft. We would expect to find in the manufacturer's literature a multiplier less than 1. The manufacturer's multiplier, correctly known as the fundamental train frequency, is 0.44. In this particular bearing, the cage completes 44% of a rotation with each rotation of the shaft. If there is a defect in the bearing cage, a fundamental train fault frequency will be generated at 0.44 times shaft speed. Let's summarize. You now know how to calculate four bearing fault frequencies: the ball pass frequency inner race, the ball pass frequency outer race, the ball spin frequency, and the fundamental train frequency. To calculate the values, the manufacturer's multiplier times the turning speed on the shaft equals the fault frequency.
Hello and welcome. This is going to be a short presentation to help you understand three different ways to understand bearing tones. Here we have a rolling element bearing with a defect on the outer race at the bottom. And as you can see, as this rotates around and the balls hit that defect, they make a little pinging sound. Ping, ping, ping. Ping, ping. And this is called a bearing tone. This is the source of vibration in the ball bearing for this type of defect. And we're going to discuss three different ways we can look at this defect. Now, the first way is called the time waveform. And as we see this graph being plotted, we have a big sine wave, which is the shaft turning around. That's this wave. And then we also can see each ball hitting the fault at the bottom makes a little click. 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 And as we said, we can see these events or these impacts directly in the time waveform. Now, if we know the amount of time between clicks or between impacts, we can calculate the frequency or the frequency of impacting. And this brings us to the second way that we can talk about this information. We can present the same information in something called a spectrum. A spectrum is a plot of frequency versus amplitude. And down here, what we see is the spectrum of the waveform above. This green peak over here coincides with the shaft rate, or this slower vibration here. The yellow peaks coincide with the rate of the balls hitting the fault on the outer race. These other yellow peaks are called harmonics. They are multiples of this first one, and they come out of this process of converting from a time waveform to a spectrum. But all of these yellow peaks are related to the rate at which that outer rate defect is getting struck by the balls. Here is a real example of actual data from a machine that describes the same thing. Here is the time waveform, and we can see there is a low frequency here, which is the shaft rate, and then we can see an impact, etc. These are repetitive hitting. Down in the spectrum, this peak coincides with the shaft rate, and this one marked in red coincides with this rate or the frequency at which this is getting hit. And again, that is our outer race defect frequency in this case. These peaks over here are harmonics or multiples of this one. They're also related to that rate at which that fault is getting hit by the balls. So that describes two ways to view that information. The first, again, is in the time waveform, where we see the impacts directly, as we can see here. The second way was looking at it in the spectrum. And the spectrum is basically asking, what is the rate at which these balls are hitting this fault? Now, the third way is to look at or listen to the sound that is made when a ball hits the defect. We can think of the ball bearing like a bell. And when the ball hits that fault, the bell rings. And when it rings, it makes a sound, and that sound is a high frequency. And that's what we are seeing here, circled. So let's look at this high frequency a little closer. Again, this is the sound the bearing makes when it gets hit. Ping! And this is a high frequency. Now, what we can do is we can use filters to filter out all of the low frequency information from this machine, where basically all of the vibration and noise the machine is creating, but not that high frequency sound that the bearing makes when it gets hit. And then we can ask, using filters, what is the rate of repetition or the frequency of the sound of the bearing ringing? So again, when I hit it once, it makes a sound. And with filters, I can ask, how frequently is that high-frequency sound occurring? Ding, 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 ding. And this technique is called demodulation. Again, the result of this is to find out what is the rate at which that dinging is happening. and that is our bearing tone frequency. It is a different way to get to the same information. Okay, this information can be presented in what's called a demodulated spectrum, or an envelope spectrum, and this is in frequency versus amplitude. And what we can see here is the frequency, or the rate at which that defect is getting struck. That's the rate at which we hear the sound of the bearing happening. We're getting hit. And because we filtered out all the other vibration from the machine, this technique is very, very sensitive. We filter out all the other vibration, and then we can zoom in on the sound of that bearing ringing, and then ask again, using filters, what's the rate at which it's getting rung. Now, because we're filtering out all that other noise, we can detect problems very early with this technique, up to even a year or more before the problem is really a problem that needs to be attended to. On the other hand, as the problem gets worse, and that's what we're seeing down here, these peaks will get higher and higher, but as it gets really bad, the noise down here will begin to raise until we're left with only noise, which is to say the demodulation goes away. So as the problem gets worse, we will not see usable information in the demodulated spectrum. So now let's do a quick review of what we've discussed. We've basically shown three different ways to look at a bearing tone. The first way was in the waveform, where we are viewing the impacts, and that's the balls hitting the fault, directly. Every time there's an impact, we see it very clearly in the time waveform. In the second method, we looked at a spectrum. And this is asking, what is the rate at which the balls are hitting that defect? And that is a graph of frequency versus amplitude. The third way to look at these bearing tones is with demodulation. And this is a way of asking, using filters, what is the sound the bearing makes when it gets hit, and how frequently is that sound occurring? Which is the same as asking, what is the rate at which the defect is getting struck? But again, it's a different way to come to that information, and it's a more sensitive way. Well, I thank you very much for attending this presentation. A little bit about the Mobius Institute. The Mobius Institute provides vibration and shaft alignment courses, among other things. These courses are given in public venues around the world. We offer private on-site courses. We also offer our courses via the internet or on CD. We provide certifications in accordance with ISO and ASNT. And our website is MobiusInstitute.com. A little bit about me. My name is Alan Friedman. I worked for DLI Engineering for 15 years. And in that job, I traveled around the world and helped install vibration monitoring programs in hundreds of facilities. I also taught vibration analysis courses to thousands of students worldwide. I've been working with the Mobius Institute for 2 years, but we've been friends for many more years than that. My email address can be found at the bottom if you have any questions. Thank you again for your time.
Okay, terima kasih.